Imagine being locked inside a small elevator with your biggest crush. Meanwhile, the AC stops working and it gets so hot, they both take off your shirts. Sounds like a dream. Well, this actually happened to me, and here's how. I was in school and my enemy Alexa made fun of me. She said, "I'm going on a date this weekend, and you? Netflix and chill with your dad?" Oh, stop it, Alexa. If I wanted a boyfriend, I could get one easily. Ha! Not in your wildest dreams. Guys just don't think that you are attractive. I wanted to prove her wrong, so I secretly went to my teacher and said, "Mr. Flanders, I know this sounds weird, but I really want to work with Jordan. Can you team us up on the next project?"
That's cute, and sure, I'll let you two write an essay together.
It was awesome. Jordan and I met up in the library for our team project. Maybe I wasn't the prettiest girl, but I had a secret weapon. Because I was absolutely shameless. I said, "So, do you have a crush on any girl in our class?" "Oh, I don't have time for dating. I only focus on school and my soccer career." "Wow, I heard you almost made the national team. Have you ever had any groupies?" "Well, girls often come into the locker room looking to have some fun, but I think it's super annoying." That's when I undid the top button of my blouse and asked, "Have you ever dated a brunette?"
"You mean like yourself?"
"Yes, and now tell me, do you find me attractive?"
Oh, stop, and let's go back to work.
Oh my god, I needed a better plan to seduce him. So I lured him into my dad's mansion. There, we had a small elevator, and I had instructed my brother to switch off the circuit breaker in the middle of the ride.
Whoa, the elevator stopped.
Yeah, it happens all the time. We just have to wait until my dad comes home and rescues us. It was so tight, Jordan's body was almost pressed up against mine. And with the AC off, it got really hot and muggy in there. So I said, "If you want to take off your shirt, please go ahead." "Well, actually, I'm fine." "Well, then, I'll go first." I peeled down to my bra and said, "It's just like a bikini. And by the way, do you think I'm attractive?"
"Oh, you sure look good."
I really thought he liked me, so I went ahead and kissed him. We kept going for 20 minutes, but right when I took his shirt off, I heard my dad scream.
"Hey, what are you doing with my daughter?"
Snap, I was in big trouble. My dad still thought I was an innocent little girl. He didn't know the real me and said,
"How dare you touch my daughter?"
"Dad, we both like each other and I'm 16, old enough to date boys and have some fun." My dad grounded me for weeks, but I didn't care. The following day, I visited Jordan after his soccer practice in the boys' locker room, and I got plenty of attention.
"Jordan, a girl is here for you, and she seems naughty."
"Oh, hey, what are you doing here?"
"I wanted to invite you to my house. I have a special surprise for you." I took him to my room and peeled down to this cute cat outfit. Meow. We kissed for a minute, then Jordan got nervous and went to the bathroom. He didn't come back for 20 minutes, so I went searching and found him talking to my brother about soccer.
"Sister, what the hell are you wearing? It's disgusting!"
I finally gave up on seducing Jordan and went to sleep. But at night I had to go to the bathroom, and that's when I heard noises from my brother's room. I opened the door and, oh my god, they were kissing! I took a photo and said, "Wow, Dad's not gonna like this."
"Oh, you witch! Please don't tell him!"
"Witch? You are my brother and just stole my boyfriend, you jerk!" I knew Dad wouldn't be happy to find out his son was into boys. So I did what any good sister would do and blackmailed him. "From now on, you are my servant. Or otherwise, I show Dad the photo. And you, Jordan? I'll let you spend 2 hours a day with my brother as long as I get the rest of the time." They both agreed. It was kind of weird sharing a boyfriend with my brother. One time we watched a movie together with Jordan sitting between us. I would kiss him for a few minutes, and then my brother would kiss him for a few minutes. But then he lost it and screamed, "Sister, I hate sharing my boyfriend with you, you freaking perv." "How dare you even speak to me, you worthless servant? Now make me a salami sandwich." My brother did whatever I ordered him to do. Sometimes I even used him as an ottoman. Meanwhile at school, I showed Jordan off to all my classmates, especially Alexa, because her boyfriend had just dumped her. I said, "Who's the loser now, Alexa? I bet your ex-boyfriend was sick of your cellulite." "Yes, I saw it in PE class, and it's disgusting." But I was drunk on power and took it too far. I told my brother, "From now on, you will flush my toilet for me."
"No way I'm gonna do that! You're disgusting!"
"Okay, then give me the laptop you got for Christmas."
"Screw you. Go ahead and out me to Dad. I don't care anymore. At least it will end this nightmare."
I fulfilled his wish and told Dad everything. He turned to Jordan and said, "So first you kiss my daughter, and then my son?" "I'm sorry, sir, but I never wanted to kiss your daughter. She's an evil monster and forced herself on me. Your son is the one I really love."
"Well, it is what it is. Sounds like my daughter will be the one making all the grandchildren in this family."
"Wait, what?"